Good morning, guys. This is Naaem Aslam, Chief Market Analyst at AvaTrade. In our today's technical analysis video, we are going to look at two important assets, and they're very different in nature. First, gold, as all of you guys must know, like what gold is, so I don't really have to explain that, but it is considered as a risk of asset. And another risk of asset is VIX, the volatility index, the implied volatility of S&P 500. What does that mean? So it means that this particular index measures the fear among investors. The lower this index is, that means that investors are ready to take more risk, and the higher the value of the VIX index is, it really tells us that the investors are not ready to take enormous amount of bullish bets. So that's what really it is. But what I'm going to look at on the backdrop of this coronavirus, I've made this chart of a similar situation, which is the SARS virus situation, took place back in 2002 to 2004 over in Asia, and I looked at the impact of that particular virus on the markets and how did these markets react to that. Now, if God forbidden, if this current virus explodes to that extent, so we will have some sort of an idea or a gauge to look at to see how far the markets can really go. Okay, so let's begin with this idea, and then we will talk about volatility index, and to finish off we will touch on gold. Now, before I continue any further, it's very important for me to discuss the risk warnings and the disclosures. So anything which we'll be discussing in this particular video cannot be perceived as an advice. If you are seeking for one, please do consult with your own financial advisor. The full risk warnings and disclosures are on our website. Please feel free to go over that and have a look at that. Now, let me pull that chart which I promised you earlier, and then let me walk you through this chart and then see what exactly it says, and then we can really talk about it. So the chart that you see in front of you is your daily chart for the Hong Kong for Hang Seng index, which we have it at AvaTrade, and your Shanghai stock index, and of course the MSCI China index. So what we're seeing is that this chart is normalized, which means that the really the gains and everything else, they start as of December 2000 as of 11th of November 2002, and then we see the performance of these indices ever since. So we can see that this particular MSCI index started to move higher as this virus situation was just about to was developing, but when it reached at its peak, we saw a massive sell-off in the MSCI index, also in the Hong Kong index, and finally also we saw the sell-off in the Shanghai index. So these indices, like as you can see, the MSCI was down to 42% from its previous peak of 82. So overall, the impact was very significant. So if anything of that nature happens again, God forbidden again, you know, we have some sort of a reference point to go through and then see how bad that impact can be on the markets. Now, the second chart that I'm showing you is the volatility index as promised. This yellow horizontal line is a 1-year average for the volatility index where it has traded mostly. So that value is at 14.94. That's where the average volatility index has traded. Now, because of the current ongoing coronavirus situation, the volatility index has surpassed its 1-year average, which is an area of interest for speculators, because what it tells you is that now there is too much fear in the market, there are less speculators in the market, and whenever there is too much fear, this is when the institutions try to jump in and then they try to make those positions. So right now you can see that the volatility index exploded to the upside with a huge upside move, and this particular move pushed the price to 18.23. Now, are we going to take another upward move? Are we ready for that? I think I will be a little bit careful because the market is running into this area of resistance. But if the narrative or if the stance of this coronavirus continues at its pace or it becomes any worse, then we can easily see this volatility index rocking and going above the level of 20, which is shown right over here. Now, to finish off, let's look at gold, because this is another safe haven asset, and then see how the performance of this precious metal has been. The chart is your daily chart, and then this is the all-time high that we have seen for gold for fairly recently, in very recent months. To be precise, I think it was in, let me just pull this one, why it is. Okay, it is not moving. Here we go. So it really happened, in January, that this was this year's high, the one that we talked about. But ever since, the price has started to go back down, but now we saw this gap to the upside, and the price is trying to really, really close that gap. Now, if I change this particular this chart on the weekly time frame, you will have a very different picture, because these 3 days or 2 days will show you a very, very bearish candle. But nonetheless, we're going to ignore that for the time being. We're going to draw our support and resistance zone. So for me, the resistance stays on top of this particular candle. And then another resistance, if I am a conserve, if I don't like to take too much of a risk, I wanted to stay above the wick of this one. So I just wanted to call these ones as a level of resistance. As a part of our level of support, I am still looking at just below this particular candle. I would like to buy this particular asset at these levels, because it just increases the odds for me. Remember to change this support zone into red color, just to keep things consistent for us. So let me just do that for you guys, so that you know, and then you can take those numbers off these charts for your reference later on. So overall, guys, I think gold is lacking, but everything else is moving and responding to this risk off asset. So this leads me to believe that there is some sort of a disconnect between the market and everything else. That's all. Thank you so much, and have a good day.